So while for some problems there's no constant factor approximation algorithm unless p equals np, or there are constant factor approximation algorithms but we know certain limits for how good that constant factor can get, there are other problems that allow for what is called a polynomial time approximation scheme. And the idea behind a polynomial time approximation scheme is basically that if you put in more running time into your algorithm, and that algorithm is called a polynomial time approximation scheme, then you will get a better solution or a better guarantee for your solution. And depending on how good you want that guarantee to be, there are then again certain implications for the running time you have to put in. So for a almost perfect solution, you will likely have to put in time that is very close to exponential time or even exponential time. And for a solution that is, well, maybe only within a rather coarse bound of an optimal solution, you will need less time. Now, the NP-complete problems that we have encountered so far obviously fall either into the category of having a constant factor approximation algorithm or admitting no such algorithm. And that is why I'm going to introduce a new NP-complete problem to you now called Knapsack. A Knapsack is very simple to describe. Knapsack gives you as input a set of objects, such as these here, and each object has a size and a value, and those are both integer numbers. So you have an integer size and an integer value. And we're soon going to do an example for this. And then additionally, you have given a container, and that container has a limited capacity. And that capacity again is an integer. And the question you're trying to answer with Knapsack is actually very simple. You're trying to ask the question, what is the maximum value that I can put into this bag here while observing the limited capacity? So the total sum of the size of the objects that I select to be in the knapsack. So say I select this object to be in the knapsack and this one here, but I don't want this one here. Then that means that the total size of these two objects cannot exceed the capacity of the container. And among all other possibilities of putting objects into the container without exceeding maximum capacity, this gives me the best possible value. And of course, here for the values, we again do the sum to calculate the total value. Knapsack is known to be NP-complete. And now let's do a little example for this problem just to familiarize yourself with this. And I'm going to give you a number of objects here. And of course, each of these objects has a size and a value. Now my question to you is, if I give you a container, and that container has size 10, which objects out of these 7 here should you put into the container to maximize the value without exceeding this size here? Please check all the items that you should put into the container to maximize the value.